Welcome back. This is part 3 of this lesson. We're going to continue immediately from the end of part 2, so let's get started. Now, the next stage of the demo lesson is to configure part 1 of the DNS integration. So what this means is to establish inbound integration from a DNS perspective. So this means that the simulated Animals for Life environment on the right can resolve DNS records that are stored on the DNS infrastructure inside the AWS environment on the left. Now, to do that, we need to create some inbound Route 53 endpoints and perform some configuration updates within the DNS infrastructure on the right. So let's get started. So let's go ahead and close down some of these tabs. We'll only need the one tab open to the AWS console. Once there, click on the services dropdown and type Route 53 and click to move to the Route 53 console. So the first step is that we're going to be creating some inbound endpoints. These are elastic network interfaces which will run in the AWS environment on the left of our architecture, and these can be used by our on-premises DNS infrastructure that's running on the right. So to create those, look on the left-hand menu under Resolver and click on Inbound Endpoints. Then click on Configure Endpoints. We're going to be configuring inbound only at this stage, so go ahead and click next to inbound only, and then click on next. For the endpoint name, type A4L inbound, and then for the VPC, click on the drop-down and select the A4L-AWS VPC. These endpoints are going to be created in the AWS side of our infrastructure. You'll need to pick a security group that will apply to this endpoint. So click in the drop-down. This is how you can configure access to these inbound endpoints. So go ahead and select the AWS security group in that list. And then inbound endpoints consist of two different IP addresses. And these IP addresses are owned by the network interfaces that are going to be created. So the way that we configure those is first, we need to pick an availability zone for this first IP address. So click in the drop-down and select US-East-1A, and then click in the subnet drop-down and you should only see a single subnet. It should be called SN-private-A. Select that, and we're going to allow AWS to assign the IP addressing automatically. Scroll down further, and now we'll set up the second IP address for this inbound endpoint. So click in Choose Availability Zone, and then we're going to pick a different availability zone. So choose US-East-1B. Click in the subnet drop-down, and there should be only one subnet listed, so select SN-private-B, and again we're going to allow AWS to automatically assign the IP address. So everything else can be left as is. Scroll down, click on Next, scroll down to the bottom of the review screen, and then click on Submit. Click on Inbound Endpoints. Now that will take a few moments to create. Once it's finished, it should move into an operational state. Once it's in an operational state, then go ahead and click on the endpoint ID. You might need to scroll down depending on the size of your font, but it should list two different IP addresses for this inbound endpoint. These are the IP addresses that we're going to need in the next step, so note both of these down somewhere safe. Now that's the AWS side of this inbound integration completed. Now what we need to do is to make some configuration changes within the simulated on-premises environment. So to do that, click on the services drop-down and then hover over EC2 and then open that in a new tab. Open that tab, click on Running Instances. We're going to need to make some changes on both of the on-premises DNS servers. So that's DNS A and DNS B. So go ahead and select DNS A first, right click, connect, session manager, and then click on connect. Now once you're connected, there's a file linked to this lesson called awszone.forward. Go ahead and open that in a text editor. And it's the configuration for a particular DNS zone, specifically aws.animalsforlife.org, which is the private Route 53 hosted zone that's running in the AWS part of our architecture. So what we need to do now is configure our simulated on-premises environment with this zone. And what this configuration will do is say that when any queries are happening inside the simulated on-premises environment, direct these queries at these forwarder addresses. And we're going to set those to be the IP addresses of the Route 53 inbound endpoints that we just created. So go ahead and select inbound endpoint IP1. So select everything from the I of inbound all the way to before the semicolon. So it should look something like this. And I want you to replace that with the first IP address of the Route 53 inbound endpoint. Now you should have noted this down earlier. So make sure that you've got your first inbound endpoint IP address in your clipboard, and then replace this placeholder. So it should look something like that, only with your IP address. Do the same for inbound endpoint IP2. Start with the I and then end before that semicolon. You'll need the second IP address. So copy that into your clipboard and just paste that in. Once you've made those changes, select everything in this file, making sure that you do have everything selected, and copy that into your clipboard. Then move back to the AWS console, and you should still have the session open to the first DNS server. So this is this DNS server, DNS A. Now there's a DNS server that's running on this Linux instance, and we're going to edit its configuration files. So they're stored in the etc directory. So type cd space /etc and press enter. And we're going to edit one of its configuration files. So we need root permissions to be able to do this. So type sudo space nano, which is a text editor, space /etc /, and then the name of the config file that we're changing, which is the config file for the DNS server. This is called named, so named.conf. So type that in and press enter. And this is the configuration file for the DNS server that's running on this Linux machine. So what we're going to do, go all the way down to the bottom of this file. Note how directly above where your cursor is, there's the zone configuration for the corp.animalsforlife.org zone. So this is the DNS zone that's running inside the simulated on-premise environment. And what we're about to paste in is the configuration for the zone that's running inside the AWS environment. So paste your clipboard into this file. Now we'll need to correct the formatting. So what we'll do, we'll scroll to the first curly brackets, go past that to the space in between and press enter. And then on that line, move to the space after the semicolon, press enter. Again, space after the semicolon, press enter. And there we go, that formatting is now corrected. So what this does is it tells this DNS server whenever there are any queries for aws.animalsforlife.org, forward them to these two IP addresses. And of course, these are the Route 53 inbound endpoints that you've just set up. So do a Control O and then Enter to save this file, and then a Control X to exit. Now, in order that this DNS server reads in this configuration file, we're going to do a restart. To do a restart, we just need to do a sudo space service space named, so named, and then a space, and then restart. So do that and press enter. Now that we've restarted the DNS service, it's loaded the config file into memory, and now it should be active. So now, just to test that, before we do the same process on the other DNS server, we'll use the command nslookup, and this allows us to perform DNS lookups. So type nslookup and press enter. We need to tell it what server to use, so we'll type server space 127.0.0.1, which means the local host, so this local server. And then we're going to make sure that it can now perform a lookup from the AWS environment. And this is using the Route 53 inbound endpoints. So it's talking to this local server, and then this local server is forwarding those queries across to the AWS side. So to test that, type web www.animalsforlife.org and then press enter. And if that's successful, you should get an answer. And architecturally, the way that this works is this query is going to the local DNS server on this Linux instance. From there, because we've added that piece of configuration for the aws.animalsforlife.org zone, it's forwarding those queries to the Route 53 inbound endpoints, and they're being used to query the Route 53 resolver, and the Route 53 resolver has that information because the CloudFormation templates have created a private hosted zone. So if we go back to the AWS console, go to hosted zones, we've got the aws.animalsforlife.org hosted zone, which was created by the CloudFormation template. And in there, we've got one single record called web.aws.animalsforlife.org, which points at both of the EC2 instances inside the AWS environment. And that's what we've just performed a query against. So we've retrieved both of the IP addresses for both of the EC2 instances that are running inside AWS. Now, to complete that process, close down this server. We need to do the same on DNSB. So right-click, connect, session manager, connect. Just make sure you've got this zone file configuration still in your clipboard. Go into the etc folder, and then with root permissions, so sudo space nano space /etc/named.conf. Go all the way down to the bottom of this file, paste that configuration in, and let's just correct the formatting. So go to the right, after the curly brace, press enter. The space after the semicolon, press enter. Again, the space after the semicolon, press enter. Save that file by pressing Control O. Exit by pressing Control X, and then restart the DNS server by typing sudo space service space named, which is the DNS service, space, and then restart and press enter. And now we've got the same configuration on the second DNS server. Now that these two on-premise DNS servers are configured to forward queries through to the Route 53 inbound endpoints, in a production environment, the next thing that you would do is configure all of your on-premises servers to use these DNS servers. So let's do that. Select the on-premises app server. Again, connect. Session manager. Click on connect. Now, the way that we can configure this Linux instance to use explicitly provided DNS servers is by editing a configuration file. To do that, we need root privileges, so sudo space nano space, and the configuration file that we want is in /etc, then a folder called sysconfig, and then in that folder, a folder called network-scripts. And then inside that folder will be different script files for all of the different network interfaces. But we're looking for one in particular, and that's the script file for the Ethernet configuration. So type ifcfg-eth0 and press enter. So this is the configuration file for the first network interface on this Linux instance. Now, you don't need to be aware of the details of this for the exam. This is fairly complex Linux configuration. But what we're going to do is explicitly provide two DNS servers to you. So go to the bottom of this file and type DNS 1 equals and DNS 2 equals. And now what we'll need is the IP addresses for both of these on-premises DNS servers. So go back to the EC2 console, select DNS A. So this is the simulated on-premises DNS A server. Copy its private IP, paste that in next to DNS 1, then get ready for DNS 2. Select the DNS B server and copy its IP address into your clipboard, paste that in. So we're now setting this instance to use both of these DNS servers that are on-premises, and these DNS servers are configured to forward queries through to AWS. So just press Control-O to save, Control-X to exit, and then we're going to do a reboot of this instance, so sudo space reboot. Press enter. That will terminate your connection to this instance. So go ahead and close that tab. Give that a couple of minutes to restart and then just right click, making sure you select the app server. Select connect, session manager, click connect again. Once you're at the terminal, you should be able to type ping space web dot AWS, because we're querying the AWS side, dot animalsforlife.org, and press enter, and you should now get both DNS resolution and a ping response. The reason for this is we've now got network connectivity between the simulated on-premises environment on the right and the AWS environment on the left, but we've also configured the inbound integration. So the DNS servers that are running within the simulated on-premises environment have been configured to forward queries through to the Route 53 inbound endpoints, and that's how we can get a result to our query, how we can retrieve the IP address, and that's what's used for these successful ping responses. So we've now done the inbound component of this demo. So this is the end of part three of this lesson. It seemed like another great opportunity to take a break. Now part four is going to continue immediately from the end of part three. So go ahead, complete this video, and when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in part four.